Hey, it's Mikey. New Call of Duty trailers have dropped. Let's meet our allies, and I will see you in just a moment.
Look, this is no ordinary German supply train. It's a fortress on wheels.
All right, there's our target.
Rizzo and I will pose as officers to infiltrate the garrison. When we blow the gates, that'll be your signal to approach. This is our one chance.
There's no turning back.
See you there.
Follow me. I'll take you to your platoon.
And you couldn't find me. Came for my parents. And my husband. And find me, my son. Tonight, everything we've lost, everything we've fought for, will mean something. Tonight, we take back our city.
So very short trailers, not too much to learn from these guys, but let's get into Major Arthur Crowley. He is part of the British Secret Service, and he's described as, after years of fighting in the British Expeditionary Force, Major Arthur Crowley serves as part of the Special Operations Executive, where he executes covert missions behind enemy lines. So he is going to be the guy that's going to get us into these stealthy missions. He shows the squad a picture of an armored train. Yes, these things were real. You have seen them in games like Battlefield. This will be very interesting how a squad of six people is supposed to take on an armored train. That's crazy. That will be a lot of fun. Stealth missions have typically been very fun and well made in Call of Duty. Now, there is a part where they do disguise themselves as German officers, and he is looking to the camera and talking to someone. He may be talking to Russo, the girl. So I'm kind of confused as if we're going to be playing the girl or if one of the officers or one of us, one of the guys in our squad, gets to play a German officer. But that would be very, very scary, very tricky if you don't know German. So I'm curious who he is talking to at that point in the trailer. One thing that was a little odd at the 22nd mark, I don't know if this was a mistake, they showed a clip of the multiplayer mode war. Were they just being lazy or did that slip in there? I have no idea why that's part of the trailer, but hey, there it is. And so we also got to meet Russo. She's described as a highly skilled French resistance fighter. Russo will do whatever it takes to fight off the Axis powers in France and avenge the ones she's lost. She's a young kid. She's 19 years old. She's only 5'3". They don't show her weight, but she couldn't be more than, like, what, 115? And she's part of the Maquis. I hope I'm saying that right. And yeah, the Maquis were real, and they actually did have women fighters. They were real people. So when they show that scene of her helping an allied soldier, they really did do that. They aided in the escape of downed allied airmen, Jews, and other people that were pursued by the German authorities. One thing that has people nitpicking about this is, we're troops from the 1st Infantry, a group of four guys. What are we doing in the middle of Paris before the liberation? You know, that was a big event. So what are we doing there? Did we take the train there? Is that how we landed there? That's a little weird. There is no recollection of that happening in history. So there is going to be some liberties taken, but maybe they do explain that. And I'm thinking they took the train that we've seen in the earlier trailer to get there. So those will be our allies. They seem really cool. They are based off of historic events. So we got to meet our squad, we got to meet our allies, and then tomorrow, which I'm excited about, they show real battles, real history. And so that comes tomorrow, and I will be posting those trailers and breaking them down for you. Get to show us some of the history behind these battles that they will be showing. And in case you missed it, I did break down yesterday's trailers. You can click on the screen or links down below.